in the heart of Las Vegas right now. A marquee event. A high-stakes clash of campaign rivals who have never gone head-to-head before. It's the Democrats' turn in the spotlight. And the final fight to be America's choice. Voters get the last word in the election of a lifetime. The people are choosing. The world is watching. And anything is possible until the last vote.
Before I began activism, I was a CFO. And I got involved in activism really on the heels of my daughter's death. My daughter, Shalynne, she was 22 years of age. She decided to move out, live with us in Las Vegas to complete her schooling to become an RN. She was working two jobs as a CNA, you know, making minimum wage. So she had worked her butt off. She was self-sufficient. When she arrived after the drive for 22 hours, she had a red swollen leg. My daughter presented to a local ER with a red swollen leg. Very important to note, she was also African-American, taking birth control. She had sickle cell trait, and she had just driven that long drive on an injured knee. These are all huge indicators that she had a blood clot. They had her calling our insurance company in the waiting room. I got phone calls. I was out of town on business, you know, that they're making us. And I was like, you know, just don't worry about this right now. We'll take care of the financial stuff later. The next call I got from her was crying in the back, and she's crying to me. I still can hear that in my head today. Mommy, they're not helping me. And I'm in so much pain. And they specifically told her when she asked for something for the pain and some further diagnostics for her leg to go get insurance and see a specialist. They were not a doctor's office. They violated EMTALA, which happens all over this country. They treat patients now as if to not find anything. It's called a wallet biopsy. And they give the bare minimum possible. And she died in my arms. And that was the defining moment in my life. So that was the thing that really got me very politically involved. I went through a long period of pain, about a year. I wasn't able to function until I heard of something called a single payer for my husband, who happened to be from Brazil. So this was nothing new to him. For me, I was like, what is that? Single payer? I'd never heard of it. So I went to a single payer conference and met Nina Turner, and she lit a fire under me. So she met me. I was just coming out of grief. I was crying. I was there talking to her. I remember her telling me, you know, I have to dig really deep. You've got to fight. And I decided to come back and do just that and fight for others. I can't save Shalynne, my daughter, but hopefully I can save other people, whether it's from health care or poverty. You know, everyone deserves to have a life and to have food on the table each and every day. I would definitely be fighting to get money out of politics. That's very important to me because I think a lot of the issues that we have all stem from a lot of our representatives being bought, for less of a better word. And also, you know, it's very important that we're addressing women's issues. Of course, Medicare for All, that's something that's very important to me. You know, we need to be addressing, you know, a livable wage and also housing. There's so many things, and they're all intersectional. And I think for anybody who's running for office or wanting to hold an office in our government, we need to be willing to fight on all fronts because they all are so intersectional. So I'm definitely looking at making sure we give back the power to the people.
Ruben Quinn is a Democratic congressman who is resigning. And he's resigning because there are multiple allegations of sexual harassment against him. And he doesn't want to run for re-election. Pretty much no way he'd get re-elected anyway. He will be stepping down at the end of his term. But what's interesting is we already have a Justice Democrat running against Ruben. Now, Amy Vilela is an absolutely incredible candidate. Listen, she has a very good chance of winning. But guess what? The Democratic establishment has decided, Amy Vilela, forget her. We're not interested in her. We don't care about her. So before Ruben even stepped down, there were countless articles about, well, this guy's future is in jeopardy, so something needs to be done. And then in the articles about this, they don't mention that he already has an opponent. So here you have a race where the Democratic establishment wants a corporate Democrat to replace Ruben, so they just pretend like Amy doesn't exist. Nope, she doesn't exist. Amazing personal story, amazing candidate, amazing platform, doesn't exist. So So look at this. This is from an article on Rubin, and oh, his political future is uncertain. They say, on the Democratic side, some potential contenders are already being discussed should Cohen decide to retire. Some names that have circulated include Representative Steve Horsford, who previously represented the seat but lost in 2014, and State Senator Yvonda Conchella, who represents Cohen's old state Senate seat. One Nevada source said Thursday that State Senator Pat Spearman and North Las Vegas Mayor John Lee have also been rumored to consider running. Are you kidding me with how pathetic this media is? I mean, that is gross incompetence at best, negligence at worst. Because let's face it, chances are the people writing articles like this, they have a direct line to Democratic leadership, to Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer and the DNC bigwigs like Tom Perez. And what are those people gonna say? Those people don't give the time of day or any consideration to backing a candidate who's actually for Medicare for All and is going to look out for the people and who's an amazing candidate with an amazing story, but we need you. We need to raise more money for her so that we can get her name out there more. And we need you to use word of mouth to talk about these candidates because there's a lot of people who don't know about them. And I really want us to come out strong for her here, because I want to show the establishment, I want to show them that their way of doing it, getting big pharma lobbyists and health insurance lobbyists to fund campaigns, that's not the only way, and that way is bad because it means you're going to do the bidding of those people. What if we had regular people fund Amy $27 at a time like Bernie Sanders? What about that? Then she'll represent the people, and they will be supporting her because of her ideology and because of what they know she's going to do for them. So let's really come out strong for Amy here.